the bell, so you know what time it is. It is gym time. Yes, boys and girls, it is week 19, believe it or not. We are still in 2021. We are finishing up our fitness testing unit. We're moving into the month of late January, into February. We'll start spring sports coming up here in a few weeks. But in the meantime, we got a new activity for you guys today. So, in week 19, we have 5 workouts. I have my assistant, Brooke, here. Say hi, Miss Brooke. Hello, hello. It helps to have an assistant because when I'm trying to demonstrate the activities or the exercises and talk about them, it's not always so easy. So if I have someone that can demonstrate it and then I can explain it, it makes things a lot better. So that's that. So we have 5 workouts for you guys today. We also have 2 very tough challenges. Now these challenges, not everybody's going to be able to do, and that's okay. I just put them in there in order to push yourselves. Just like we did goal setting with fitness testing, you set a goal, you try to push yourself. These 2 challenges, they're tough, are gonna try to put, you're gonna have to try to push yourself in order to complete them. So if you can't do them, don't get discouraged. I probably can't even do them, so that's okay. After we do our workouts, we're gonna get into relays. We're gonna get into 5 different relays, and we'll talk about what relays are right now. So let's spin the board here, and we get to our definition. So, our word of the week, is relay. You say, Mr. L, what is a relay? I'm gonna tell you. A relay is a group of people engaged in a task. So a group of people doing one task, right? Or an activity for a fixed period of time and then replaced by a similar group. So that's just a fancy definition of saying you have a team or a group of people doing a task for a set amount of time, like example, running a lap in track, and then replaced by another person. So in the Olympics, they run relay races. They take a baton, they run a lap, they pass it to their partner runs a lap. Once they've all completed their lap, the race is over, whoever gets done first wins. Well, today we're gonna do relay races individually. You're gonna either verse a family member, or you'll use a stopwatch and verse yourself. You'll do them like 1 or 2 or 3 times and try to get a faster and faster time. Or if you're like me, you'll get some wins and you'll verse a family member and you'll beat them easy breezy. Right, Brooke? Oh, she said right. She said that's right. So we'll see what's going to happen. Let's get into our 5 exercises right now. Okay. Our first exercise is going to be something called airplane twists. Now, they call it an airplane twist. Can you scoot up a little bit, Brooke? Maybe like right here? They call it an airplane twist. Come to the middle. There we go. They call it an airplane twist because you're going to put your arms out. Arms out. And then you're going to touch your toe, but the opposite foot and the opposite hand. So you're going to go across your body, and then you're going to touch. And then you're going to go across your body, and you're going to touch. You're going to do this 10 times. Now, what you're not going to do, what you're going to try not to do, is if I try it, I'm so big, I have to like bend all the way over. You don't want to be bending over. The goal is to remain upright, extend your legs, stretch, test your flexibility, get it all the way up and try to touch that toe, all the way up and try to touch it again. You'll do that 10 times. This is called the airplane twist. Okay, very good job, bro. Our next activity is called the hop switches. For this, you'll need some type of a circle. You can make a circle with chalk, you could put some socks, you could take an extension cord. You don't need an actual hoop. You can use anything that's a circle. What you're gonna do is you're gonna put 1 foot in it and 1 foot out of it, and you're gonna try to switch your feet going around the circle. Brooke will demonstrate as we go. Here she goes. She's alternating feet and she's rotating around the circle. Very good job. So that's called hop switches. You're hopping off the ground and you're switching your feet as you're making your way around the circle. Remember, you don't need a hula hoop. You can use anything that's a circle to complete this task. Okay, our next activity is going to be called shoulder taps. So for this one, we're gonna use the mat. You don't necessarily need a mat. You can do it on the ground, preferably anything soft, just to be safe. But we'll do something called shoulder taps. So, Brooke will get into almost like a plank position. Brooke, can you go that way? And face the camera. There we go. Yep. And then just scoot back a little bit. There we go. Perfect. And then she's going to take one hand and touch her shoulder. And then she'll take her other hand and touch the opposite shoulder. She's going to repeat that 10 times. Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now, what you're doing is you're remaining in a plank. So you keep your plank, you keep your body position kind of on a little angle. Then you're going to use your upper body strength and your core strength to hold yourself up and then alternate arms to touch each shoulder. Excellent job, Brooke. Well done. Okay, our next activity is called mountain climbers. So for this one, you may or may not need the mat, but you're going to get down into position. Brooke will demonstrate as I will demonstrate, and you're going to alternate your feet. So you go down like this, kind of almost in a semi, like a racing start, and then you're gonna put your hands on the ground, and you're gonna switch your feet, acting like you're climbing a mountain. You'll do that 10 times. So that's called the mountain climbers. Now, when you put all of these together, you're gonna get super tired. So if that's the case, take a break, get some water, catch your breath, and then do the next one. All right, our next exercise is called the weighted arm circles. This one can be super tough. Now, some of you are saying, Mr. Al, I don't have weight. That's okay. Look what we're using for weight. We're using water bottles. Now, we're gonna use water bottles, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna put your arms out, and then you're going to rotate them in a circle for 30 seconds with the weight to make it even harder. Brooke, are we ready? Set, go. So she's going, and we're gonna set the watch down. 30 seconds. Now, if these are too heavy, Brooke, what could you do?
You could drink some of this.
Oh, very smart idea. She could drink some of the water if they get too heavy, and it'll make it a little bit lighter. Remember, you don't want your arms to slouch down. You don't want them to bend. You wanna keep them nice and tight, straight out. We're at 25 seconds. We got 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, and go. Woo! I just did that for maybe about 20 seconds and I can feel it in my arms. You would do that forwards 3 times and then you would do it backwards 3 times. And that would be a great arm exercise, a great workout. We have not done anything with weights this year. This is the first thing that we're trying with weights. Okay, excellent job, Brooke. Now, we're going to get into one of the challenges. Remember, these are super tough. If you can't do it, that's okay. The first one is the ball push-up. Here we go, let's demonstrate. I'm gonna grab a ball, Brooke has a ball. You're going to get into push-up position. And in push-up position, you're gonna put one hand on the ground and one hand on the ball. Determine which hand you want to be on the ball and the other one on the ground. So I'm gonna put my right hand, which is my dominant hand, on the ball, and I'm gonna put my non-dominant hand on the ground. And you're gonna try to do a push-up with one on the ball and one on the ground. Control the ball, don't let it roll away from you, and try your push-up. Are you ready, Brooke?
Yeah.
Let's give it a shot. And down, 1, down, 2, down, 3, down, 4, down, 5. Oh my goodness, we just did 5. I can feel it already. It's very challenging, it's very tough. You would switch it to the other hand and you would try 5 more. Our last challenge is called the side plank tuck. Now, Brooke is gonna continue to use the weight. She's going to get on a mat. Again, you don't need a mat. We're just doing it because our floor is hard. So she'll get into kind of like a plank position, but on her side. And she's gonna hold one arm all the way up, straight up. And she's gonna try to take that weight and tuck it under. She'll do that 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. She is doing it on her forearm. You could also try to do it with just your arm down and being straight on a plank. So whatever way you try to do it, you can modify it. Keep your weight. You would do that 5 to 10 times, then switch arms and do it the other way 5 to 10 times. So that is our 5 exercises and our 2 challenges. That's an excellent workout. If you guys can do those 2 challenges, make sure you let me know. Okay, We're going to now progress into the relays. So, Brooke is gonna move a couple things and we'll start our relays. Give us 1 second. Let's just slide the camera back. Sorry about that, guys. We have to move the camera a little bit. I'm on the struggle bus here. And of course it doesn't want to sit straight. All right, there we go. So we're going to start on the wall, and we're only going to go to half court. You can make these as far as you want or as close as you want, whatever you so choose. So if you want to make them long relay races, go for it. If you want to make them short relays, try that too. Now, normally we would have teams. There would be like four players on a team. One person would go, come back, and then they switch the next player. The first team done would win. But because we're at home, we don't have teams, so we're gonna do it individually, race a family member, or like I said, use your stopwatch and do it by yourself. So the first one we have is the skip. So we're gonna skip there, skip back. Next is shuffle, one hop, beanbag balance, and then a spoon balance. So here we go. We'll do maybe three of them just for time. Okay, let's start with the skip, and we'll do the one hop. Are you ready, Brooke? We pick a destination, we'll go to half court. Set, go. We're gonna skip half court, and go back. Skip the half. Oh my goodness, I beat Brooke, that's one win for me. The next one we're gonna try, we'll do the one leg hop. Let's do the one leg hop. We'll hop one leg there, and hop one leg back. Set, go. Oh, she's a little faster than me on this one. I switch legs all the way. She's trying to beat me. Oh, she won on that one. So it is 1-1 between the two of us. The next one we'll do is a bean bag balance. So Brooke's gonna grab her bean bag. We're gonna put the bean bag. You can try it either on the back of your hand and do it. We're gonna do it on our heads and try to balance it on our head. Are you ready, Brooke? On your marks, get set, go. Balance a beanbag. Again, you can use anything. You don't have to have a beanbag in order to do this. You can use a pillow or a stuffed animal, anything, or a book. Oh, I beat her. 2-1, my lead. The last one you're gonna try, this one is a little tricky. We're gonna use a little stuffed animal. What are you using, Brooke?
SpongeBob!
I'm gonna use Patrick. So I'm gonna use Patrick. What you're gonna do is you're gonna put a spoon in your mouth. You're gonna balance something, any object, there and back. Let's see if we can do it. Here we go. All right. Hang on, cheater. I'm going to put my arm on your mark. Get your go. Oh, yeah! I cheated a little bit, and I got a lead. I get to half court, and I'll turn around. Uh-oh, she's struggling. She's cheating. Oh, my goodness. What a cheater, pumpkin eater. All right, folks, that's our lesson for the week. 5 workouts, 2 challenges, and 5 separate relays. You can skip there, you can shuffle there, one hop there, you can do a beanbag balance, and then try the spoon balance. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.